every plant, every animal, every insect, and microbe has its own place and purpose. The universe is like a vast interconnected network. We are not individual islands, but a common chain.
Kerala has experienced the worst floods of the century. More precisely, since 1924. Was it a natural disaster or a man-made one? Kerala has been devastated.
How did this happen? Will it happen again in Kerala? Will it happen in Mumbai, Goa?
The climate has changed drastically over the past 2 to 3 decades. We have high level of pollution in air, water, and land.
These pollutants don't degrade easily. Collect in the atmosphere as colloidal particles, which in turn collect water droplets
and form huge clouds that lead to frequent cloud bursts. The frequency of such cloud bursts has increased during the past few decades.
This has happened with tragic consequences in Mumbai, Uttaranchal, and now Kerala.
Every citizen is equally responsible for such devastation. And when nature is back, we laugh.
We count our losses and continue throwing up again and again.
We ignore the importance of red clay.
We ignore the sensitivity of ecologically fragile lands.
And in cities, we build buildings on leveled farmlands.
After surprising,
in the name of development, we hurt nature, boring, mining. We construct buildings and block waterways illogically.
We think there will be no backlash, but this rain has given us lesson.
Let us very seriously take stock of the problem here.
How can we protect Mother Earth from this abuse?
We need to be better stewards.
What does that mean?
Stewardship means protecting or looking after something. It is our duty to look after the world in which we live, as God gave us this responsibility. This responsibility means that we must take care of our planet, treat it with respect.
The environment is in us, not outside. The trees are our lungs, the river our bloodstream, the air our breath, and the earth our body.
We are all interconnected, and what you do to the environment, ultimately you do to yourself.
Every worm, every insect, every animal is working for the ecological well-being of the planet.
Only we humans, who claim to be the most intelligent species here, are not doing that.
We humans.
Yes, nothing in nature lives for itself. The river doesn't drink itself.
No.
Trees don't eat their own fruit.
No.
Live for one another is the rule of nature.
We abuse land and regard it as a commodity belonging to us.
When we see land as a community we belong, we may begin to use it with love and respect.
And trillions of one killing the life of this one. And the number of planets we can live on.
Don't believe in climate change.
We are living on this planet as if we have another one to go.
How can we protect? All of us are responsible for how we use our planet.
We need to think what we can do to safeguard the future and not abuse the trust
that has been given to us.
The greatest threat to our planet is the belief that someone else will save it.
And we wait for someone to come and save the planet.
Thank you.